Good day, my listeners out there. This is Destiny Capsule coming your way today. My name is Yomi Eniola, presenter of Purpose and Destiny Awareness. This is the broadcast that comes to you on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday to give you the mind of God as you go and to also strengthen you, to give you the assurance that your destiny and purpose on the earth is achievable. Today is 7th of October 2020, and I pray that God Almighty is going to be with you all my listeners out there. May today open itself for you, and everything you do today is going to prosper in Jesus' name. The word of the Lord says, day to day utter their speech, and I pray that everything that today is going to be uttered will be in your favor in the name of Jesus. Nothing work against you. Everything is working for you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And also, before I go into the broadcast today, I want to celebrate and appreciate the grace of God upon my brother, Reverend Oluwayemi John Eniola, the one who God is using in Ogun State. And I say that happy birthday to you, man of God, and everyone that today is your birthday. I celebrate you, and I pray that the favor of the Lord is going to rest upon your life in the name of Jesus. New grace, new anointing for greater accomplishment in purpose and destiny in Jesus' name. What has not been working will begin to work for you in the name of Jesus. I say happy birthday to everyone whose today is your birthday celebrating. You will have more to celebrate in goodness and favor and blessing and good strength in Jesus' name. Amen. Today's topic is anointing makes the difference. Anointing makes the difference. And a Bible text is taken from the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, and I read verse 38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God is with him. Praise God. Now, looking at this place, this is one of the major secrets that we see in the life of Jesus Christ. Without the anointing, Jesus would not have been able to accomplish anything tangible on the earth. If you look at the life of Jesus Christ, when he was born till the age of 30, there was nothing extraordinary that was reported that he did throughout those years. But when he appeared before John the Baptist and he was baptized in the water, the Bible said the heaven was opened upon him, and then the Holy Ghost descended upon him. At that time, the Spirit led him into the wilderness, and he was there for 40 days fasting and praying, and also he was tempted of the devil. But the Bible said when he returned in the power of the Holy Ghost, and the Bible said that people began to receive their healing and testimonies began to come, and the fame of Jesus Christ spread round about. What actually brought difference into the life of Jesus was the anointing. The secret of that exploit is what scripture revealed to us in Acts chapter 10 verse 38, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. Now I want you to look at something critical there, that the Bible did not say how God anointed Jesus the Son of God. No, the Bible says that how God anointed Jesus Christ. The scripture revealed Jesus to us as a Nazarene, as somebody who was born in the city of Nazareth, who has a father, biological father, and a biological mother. So the scripture revealed to us that Jesus Christ came from the city of Nazareth, just like you coming from the city where you come from. That was exactly the way the scripture revealed Jesus to us, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth, not Jesus the Son of God. So the exploit that Jesus was able to accomplish was not because he was the Son of God, but because he was anointed by the Holy Ghost. And the Bible said when the Holy Spirit came upon him, the Bible said he went about and then he began to do good, and then he was healing and delivering everyone that are oppressed of the devil. Because of the anointing upon him, the presence of the Lord was always with him. So it's important, you need to understand that when you crave for the anointing, it doesn't matter the city you are born, it doesn't matter the country you come from, if you have craved for the anointing and the anointing of the Lord come upon your life, it's going to make difference upon anything you do. It's going to make a difference upon your ministry. It's going to make a difference upon your business. It was by the anointing of the Holy Ghost that Daniel was able to become the leader and became president in the land of Babylon. It was by the anointing that Joseph became prime minister in the land of Egypt. It was the anointing of the Lord that came upon Moses that helped him to liberate the children of Israelite from the hand of Egyptians. And the same anointing is still available today. That was the secret that was in the life of Jesus Christ. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth. So I want to know that you, from the city or the village where you come from, if you can go for the anointing, there is going to be difference upon your life and your experiences. Now, one thing you need to understand about the anointing is that the anointing is the only thing that the devil does not have answer for. Anointing is one thing that the devil does not know how to handle. So if it is your brain, the devil can handle that. If it is your academic, the devil is not a dollar. If it is your money, the devil also promises people the riches of the world. He said unto Jesus, "Could you see the world and the riches and the power and the glory?" He said, "All these were given to me, and whosoever I want, I give it to." So the devil also has level of riches. In fact, the one that you have without God is actually coming from the devil. And if you are blessed, make sure that your blessing is coming from God. So it's necessary for you to know that your money is not the answer to what you need. But the anointing is the one that solves everything. Anointing is the hardest currency. It can solve any problem, business problem, health problem, marital problem, financial problem, academic problem, whatever crisis that the devil is bringing around your life. One thing the devil is yet to find an answer for is the anointing. And that's why I'm bringing this word to you today, that you need to go for the anointing of the Lord. The secret of how to receive the anointing was written in Psalm 45 by David. Look at Psalm 45, I read verse 7. Psalm 45, verse 7. It said, "Thou lovest righteousness and hatest wickedness. Therefore, God, thy God, has anointed thee with the oil of gladness that kept you above your fellows." So one of the criteria that will get you the anointing of the Holy Ghost is that you need to hate wickedness and love righteousness. When you begin to live holy life, that is when your prayer and your fasting could actually be acceptable to God, and God can bring the power of God upon you. And I pray that today, let the anointing of the Holy Spirit rest upon you to make difference in everything that you do, in the mighty name of Jesus. Can I have a word of prayer with you before we go? Father, in Jesus' name, I pray for this, my friend and my brother, my sister, listening to this broadcast right now. I pray that the anointing of the Lord is going to come upon his life. It's going to touch everything around them. Anointing of the Lord that breaks yokes, that destroys the power of darkness, that heal the sick. Let the anointing of the Lord come upon you right now in the name of Jesus. Every one of you that are sick and listening to this broadcast, let the anointing of the Lord for healing be released upon you in the name of Jesus. Every holds of Satan over your life, I command them broken and destroyed in the name of Jesus. Those of you that have been affected by family ancestral curse, I command right now, by the anointing that breaks yokes, let the yokes of family ancestral curse be broken away from your life in the name of the Lord Jesus. Be released out of that bondage in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Those of you outside there that your business is being affected, is being attacked, I pray right now that the anointing to prosper, let it come upon your business in the name of Jesus. I rebuke the hand of the devil away from your business, away from your finances, away from your child, away from your marriage, everything around you to receive the anointing to prosper, anointing to function in the name of Jesus. From this moment on, let there be major difference upon your life, your health, your business, your career, your academics in the name of Jesus. I sense in my spirit that somebody is hearing this broadcast right now and you have a problem that you easily forget things. I pray that the anointing of the Lord that opens a man's brain, let it come upon you and work upon your brain in the name of Jesus. Everything that makes you forgetful, I rebuke that away from you in the name of Jesus. And let the anointing for remembrance come upon your life in the name of Jesus. It is well with you. As you go today, go and prosper. The anointing of the Lord is going to be upon your life. It's going to teach you and lead you and protect you in the name of Jesus. Your day is blessed and favored in the name of the Lord Jesus. I pray for you that the hands of the Lord be upon you in Jesus' name. And I say again to every one of you that are celebrating your birthday with my brother today, Reverend Oluwayemi John Eniola. Every one of you celebrating birthday today with him. I pray that today will become a beginning of a new, greater experience in your life in Jesus' name. I say happy birthday to all of you, and I love you with the love of God. God bless you. If you need any inquiry or you want to get in touch with me, you can send your message to me on WhatsApp on this number, +234 8067550234. Again, +234 8067550234. Send a message to me, and God is going to give you an answer of peace. And you can also share your testimony with us on how the broadcast is blessing you. And be free to share this broadcast on your group page, on your Facebook, or whatever. And let it be a blessing to somebody out there. Till I come your way again on Friday, keep on fulfilling purpose and destiny. God bless you.